The CEO of Adani Mining has praised the Queensland government for what it calls a significant shift over its proposed coal mine. The Indian mining giant met with government officials in Queensland today, ahead of the expected announcement tomorrow of a timeline for approvals.
The controversial Adani coal mine is back in the headlines after Labor's poor showing in Queensland and suggestions that delays over the mine cost Labor the election. Today, the Queensland Labor Premier was blunt about claims she stepped in to fast-track the mine's approval to save her job.
Rubbish.
Adani's CEO met with Queensland government officials today after Premier Palaszczuk said she was fed up and wanted a time frame for the mine delivered by tomorrow.
The engagement that we've had today and the constructive nature of the meeting has certainly emboldened us in terms of the level of support that we're seeing from the Queensland government. So we're encouraged and we're looking forward to getting on board and starting the project.
Adani claims the mine will create more than 8,000 jobs. The federal government wants Adani operational as soon as possible.
A loud message was sent from North Queensland to Canberra on the weekend that they want jobs. They want opportunity, and that's why the Queensland Labor government just needs to get off their backside and approve this mine ASAP.
One mine that won't be recruiting new workers anytime soon is China Stone. It's the mine right next door to Adani's Carmichael site. The company didn't say why, but announced it has abandoned its bid for a mining lease.
The reason that we hear today that a Chinese mine isn't going ahead, the reason we hear that BHP is withdrawing further from coal, is that the vast majority of people around the world think that the demand for coal is going to shrink, not rise.
If the Adani mine doesn't go ahead, lawyers say the Indian giant could sue the Australian government for billions of dollars under a treaty between India and Australia. Legal experts say Adani's been playing hardball to get the mine across the line.
So they've been saying that if the project is not approved, then foreign investors will perceive Queensland to be an unsafe and unwelcoming investment environment and they won't go ahead with other projects. And that's clearly a tactic to put pressure on the Queensland government.
Tomorrow's announcement should make clear the timing of the approval process for the mine. Felicity Davey,